U.S., President Joe Biden claims he has bipartisan support for legislation to fund the semiconductor industry. Now, in a meeting with auto executives and other business leaders, Biden said he will urge Congress to invest $50 billion in semiconductor manufacturing and research as part of his broader focus to rebuild the U.S. manufacturing industry as a powerhouse. The funding will be part of Biden's $2.3 trillion infrastructure plan.
For too long as a nation, we haven't been making the big, bold investments we need to outpace our global competitors. We've been falling behind on research and development and manufacturing. And put it bluntly, we have to step up our game. And I'm not ready to give up. I'm ready to work with all of you, with the Congress, both parties, to pass the American Jobs Plan and to make a once-in-a-generation investment in America's future again.
Wall Street stumbling from records overnight as investors wait for the upcoming earnings season and a key inflation report that's due out later this week that could give clues as to whether the U.S. economy is overheating or not. Annual inflation rate in the U.S. increasing to 1.7% in February from 1.4% in January, the highest inflation rate since February last year. All three major indices in the U.S. in the red, with the S&P 500 closing below its previous record close, the tech-heavy NASDAQ leading the declines as it dropped over 0.3%. Traders also noting recent comments from U.S. Federal Reserve Chair Jerome Powell, who said Washington's economy is at an inflection point.
You're seeing selling pressure on the market simply because investors are concerned about whether or not earnings will come in ahead of these revised estimates that have been set by Wall Street analysts. And let's face it, the market has run a significant distance in a very short period of time. And so people are getting a little bit nervous and they're wondering kind of what's next in this market.
Taking a look now at U.S. stock futures, it seems like it's going to be a green open when they do assume trade tonight. Green, but mostly flat, very modest gains there. Now, over here in Asia, markets are trying to shrug off the muted trading stateside, with markets in Japan, South Korea, and Australia all in the green. The Kospi index leading gains up by 0.5%. Investors also seem to continue monitoring shares of Chinese tech giant Alibaba. This after Beijing Central Bank said its affiliate Ant Group will restructure as a financial holding company. This comes days after Alibaba was hit with a $2.8 billion antitrust penalty as China tightens controls on the so-called platform economy.